clock, so you know what it is. This is DJ Boz.
This is Rickey D, man.
And this is the Sports Show About Nothing. You know what it is. It's March Madness. March Madness, so we got UAB's finest in the house to talk March Madness, talk UAB losing the other day. I know that's going to hurt his heart. We got the one and only Mo Finley in here, everybody. Everybody give him a round of applause.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Thank you. First off, Mo, thank you again for coming.
Appreciate you.
What, did you even watch the game?
Which one?
Last week, UAB's loss.
Yeah, I watched both. It's, man, it's like watching your little brother get picked on, man.
Yeah.
Like, there's no other way to describe it. It was bad and tough to watch, but it happened.
So what, like, first of all, before I ask this question, I'm gonna give you my opinion on it. I think Nick Norton shot us out in the second half. Because if you have Robert coming out as hot as he is.
Which game? The BYU game?
Yeah, what? BYU.
I don't think he shot us out. I think he has to take shots. Like, he has to be aggressive. Like, if not, it's easy to go out one guy. Yeah. So the other dudes, he gotta take shots too.
Man, ball screen the death for Robert. Because he's coming off the screen, jacking them from, like, almost half court and swishing them.
But that's hard to do for, that's hard to sustain for 30 minutes, man. That's hard to do.
I agree. But he came out and hit the first 11 points for UAB.
Yeah. I mean, well, Robert, yeah, eventually they make good teams make adjustments. So he couldn't come out there and do that for 20 whole minutes. He could, but it's a lot easier if somebody else is taking shots and making a few too.
Mm-hmm. Man, I guess I see what you're saying, but I just don't think that the shots that Nick took, he should have taken in those moments.
They weren't good shots.
I don't feel they were because Robert came down and they gave him a BS offensive foul call.
Yeah, I thought it was a bad call.
And he would have started the game 7-for-7. Like he would have. I'm sorry, not second the game, half. The second half.
Yeah.
He would have started the second half 7-for-7, but. You know, it's over and done. We're looking on to next year. But I feel like Nick took a lot of bad shots.
Nick Norton has to shoot those balls, man. It sounds bad. I mean, it looks bad because you're looking at the final number. You know, you're looking at the stats. But he has to shoot them. If he doesn't take those shots, it's a lot easier to guard Robert Brown. Somebody else has to be to make an outside shot.
And what happened with what's the big man's name? Why is
Tosin Mahinte?
Yeah, why is he not playing it? Why did he not play as much as he normally did?
That I don't. Y'all gotta get Jared Hassan here. That I don't know. But I would imagine maybe just a matchup deal. Maybe you want.
But he didn't play much conference though. Yeah. He didn't
maybe play it's much a matchup problem there too. Maybe it's a. There has to be a reason, you know, that he didn't play. It's gonna sound. I don't know. Maybe it won't sound bad, but I trust Coach Hass. So if Coach Hass doesn't have him in the game, I trust they've had enough success where I don't question anything Coach Hass does. Yeah. So for me, I think it had to be something personnel-wise that made them keep him on the bench.
It's hard to question 26-6.
That's the best thing in history, man. I'm sick to my stomach. Like sick. And I don't even play anymore. I'm sick.
They said if they would at least made the conference finals,
they may have gotten in.
Yeah.
But to me, part of the problem is this. You know, Conference USA, we all can kind of agree, isn't what it used to be from top to bottom. And that makes, you know, I get it. But there's no way, in spite of the past two games, there's no way UAB is one of the top 68 teams in the country.
That's true.
On paper, maybe not because you're looking at who they played. But they passed the eye test from a basketball standpoint.
So let me ask you this. Would the solution be changing conferences? And if so, who'd take us?
But can you change the conference now? Since Conference USA stuck by us when we didn't have football?
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
That.
Like, that almost seems a little bit, you know, when we didn't have football, kind of
said no more parties in L.A. No loyalty in this thing.
Yeah, you can't. I mean, you can be that guy, but do you want to be that guy that says, you know what, the conference isn't good enough for us. We want out, and they stuck by us when we didn't have football. So I don't know if that's necessarily the answer. I think, hopefully, we'll be able to schedule tougher opponents. But the problem is nobody wants to play us.
I think another problem is just in whole, the NCAA, how they go by picking the 64, 68, is it's awful. You take the best teams, man.
The best teams don't always make it, though.
Yeah.
But the best teams have never always made the tournament.
But they should.
They've always had years where the best teams didn't make it. So
is it more or less a process in picking the team that's flawed? Is that what we're getting at? That the process in picking the best 64 teams is flawed?
Well, I don't know if the process is flawed, but here's the issue. For example, Holy Cross. Holy Cross has a losing record, right?
Yeah.
They weren't the best team in their conference.
19 games.
Yeah, but they won at the right time. So for sure, they're not they're one of the 68 teams. Nowhere they're top 68 teams in the country. There's a team in their conference that's a better team.
Yeah.
But because of the conference they play in, because they lost at the, you know, if they won at the right time, they're in. Yeah. But it's always been that way.
You gotta
sound bad, but it's true.
You gotta change that, man. They gotta do something about that. I mean, because
you got cash. You can change it.
That's
you
what it's all about. Man, well, that's what it's about.
Can we swipe our EBT cards?
Well, I don't know if that's gonna. Yeah, no, it may not be sufficient.
Not for that type of money.
But I don't know, man. I would love to see I mean, if you add more teams, I mean, that just kind of makes it worse. Because if you add more teams, that makes it solely, completely about the money.
Yeah.
So let me ask you this. What conference do you, like, if we, you know, if we're the commissioners of the conference, right, and we say that we want to take UAB on as a participant in our conference, what conference do you best see UAB in?
And that's saying that another conference is willing, right?
Right. And that's saying that another conference is actually suiting UAB.
I would say maybe just from a geographical standpoint, because I think that's been kind of thrown out the one. Like now teams, the Connecticut and Tulane are in the same conference. What's the conference?
The American.
Yeah, like UAB could possibly fit in there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because geographically, of course, I'm assuming that it doesn't matter which part of the country you're in as long as you meet certain criteria and if you're wanted.
Right.
So I would like to see us there. I can't see in any other conference. You know, geographically speaking, I can't see where it would fit. So you can't go to the WAC. You can't go, I don't
ACC.
Think the ACC, well, the ACC, you can't go to the ACC.
Yeah,
I don't think they would allow it. I don't think they don't have, why, what do they gain from allowing UAB in, you know?
They gain football and the best hospital in the
country. Yeah.
Football.
No. Too bad you can't sell surgery rights. Nobody wants to see surgery on TV.
But yeah, man, all of us were at the game. What was that, Thursday?
Last Thursday.
When they lost them.
West, you know, Kentucky.
It was heartbreaking. I'm with you. I'm sick about it, too. I told one of my good friends, Marcus, like, I just think they're going to come out flat today. Like, I told him that verbatim. Like, I think they're going to come out flat today, and they came out flat.
Last Thursday, which is a little different than the game at BYU, but last Thursday, for me, it kind of seemed like, you know, I don't know if they were more relaxed or maybe a little too relaxed. Mm-hmm. It's hard to beat a team, you know, multiple times in a year. And this is like the third time they've seen Western Kentucky. At their spot, you know, they lost at Western Kentucky. They won at UAB. So maybe, you know, the players know that if we don't win the tournament, we might not get in.
Right.
So maybe in order to try not to come out too tight, maybe you try to relax a little too much, and what you get is, like you said, you come out flat. But a lot of shots that we normally make just didn't go. Like all the 50-50 balls, you know, turnovers, loose balls and stuff that we've gotten all season, we didn't get them. And, like, it's hard to – you can't really plan for that.
One number that was just, like, out there was Western Kentucky had 50 rebounds to – 28 to UAB.
Yeah. And that's an energy deal. That's all. I mean, that's, like I said, they come out, you come out flat. Uh-huh. That's an energy thing. They came out the aggressor, and it's, you know, nowhere does it show up more so than in that, you know, the rebounding stat.
Yeah. Man. Missing layups and
like that. Sometimes, man, it's just not your night. Like you miss a layup, a shot that normally goes in. Sometimes those shots just don't go in.
Yeah.
Nothing you can do about it.
You're right, man. Cause Purdue. I have no clue how they lost to. Well, I do know how they lost. Arkansas Little Rock scored more points than Purdue did. But for them to, like, I had Purdue in my Elite Eight.
Yeah, that's over.
For real?
Yes.
Wow.
I had Purdue in my Elite Eight. And who in the world, if you tell me and you're not a Yale alum that you pick Yale, like, I'm taking stock tip from you from now on out. because nobody in their right mind would have picked Yale over Baylor.
No, and I picked Baylor, and I was sick. I'm like, really?
I like to see the team. I like to see the underdogs win.
I mean,
I do. I don't root for. I mean, a team that hadn't been in the tournament in 50 years, you couldn't root for them for one day.
It's their first win ever.
Yeah, I mean, they're not going to win next week. They're not going to win tomorrow, but rooting
for them and thinking that they're going to win is two totally different things. Because I had no idea that they were going to win. Like, I had Baylor going out the next round, but I still had them beating Yale.
The thing about it, people don't really even watch those games until their conference tournament. Like, I can't even find Yale on TV. Right. Maybe only near their campus or some type of student access channel. You can't see that on. Yeah. You can't see them on TV. So
you know, the guys that go to Duke was turned down by Yale, and the guys that go to Yale were turned down by Harvard.
That's crazy. I believe that too. So, big games today. We have Dayton. And who is Dayton playing today?
Syracuse. Speaking of Syracuse, bro, how Syracuse make the tournament with a 19-13 record? Seriously.
They just got hot at the right time. Did they win their conference?
No.
They didn't?
No. And Jim Boeheim, you know, was suspended for 9 games early in the season.
For what?
Mid-season.
For what?
Off the, what happened, the violation?
Yeah, something with them not... I think the classes or something.
They said they were doing homework for the players and
oh yeah,
man, that's study hall. Volunteering, you know what I'm saying?
That's study hall, man. What are you talking about?
Nobody ever did my homework. I went to study hall all the time.
But Syracuse is beating Dayton right now. Our producer Maddox said.
And then you know they came off of last year where they was banned for total. They couldn't go to the NCAA tournament at all last year. It's like they just had to rush to put them in that issue.
Dang.
I think when you play in a bigger conference, you get the benefit of the doubt.
Yeah.
You know, think about the team. What's the team? Mama. They've been doing all the dancing all year. The bench has
very
been on sport. Yeah, you know, but at the end of the day,
it didn't pay off for them.
They play in a crappy conference, and they play well, but they don't get the benefit of the doubt. And I see it.
So, like us, basically.
70-50. That's the final? Okay. All right. 70-50. Syracuse is up. Man, what's up? How did Creighton? Well, I guess they didn't win their conference, but they've been a regular in the actual tournament over the past 8 years, 9 years. They've been every year except for this year.
Did they win their conference tournament every year?
Yeah, I'm assuming, because I'm not sure.
But Creighton be in and out the top 25.
And that's the thing. Like, if you can, like, for the teams that play in a smaller conference or a mid-major conference, if you can get quality people to play you. Over the course of the, you know, your non-conference schedule, if you play well, if you win one or two of them, let's say you go 500, and then you play well in your conference, you get the benefit of the doubt because you played a couple of teams out, you know, you played a couple of the Power Five teams, and you had some success against them. They'll give you the benefit of the doubt, but I don't know. Maybe Creighton, maybe they're not as good this year, or if they played some teams in the Power Five conference, maybe their non-conference schedule, they didn't have as much success as in years past. So that could be part of it too.
So would the basketball also work like football where you get the home and home?
It depends. Sometimes. Some people will play. I got, for example, when I was a freshman, Auburn played us. We played at their spot. And then we didn't play them again. And when Coach Anderson got here, they wanted us to come to their spots like 7 years in a row. And then they were going to come and play us at the Civic Center. Like, who does that? Like, if you're going to play me on my campus, if I'm willing to come and play you on your campus, you have to be willing to play me on my campus.
Yeah.
But some schools aren't willing to do that.
And it's Auburn basketball. Like, get over yourself.
Exactly.
But they probably just think about the fans that's here in the Birmingham Metro.
But forget, no, it's not that. Because the thing is, if you're going to do it that way, you can have it. The same people drive 2 hours up to 280. Real basketball fans drive up to the Civic Center every year.
Yeah.
So just, let's do it. If we're going to play every year, let's just play there every year. That way, you don't have a gripe about me not coming to your campus or vice versa. Mm-hmm. Play at the Civic Center. But they didn't want to do that. So Coach Anderson said no.
I don't blame him. Man, other big games. Did anyone have Arizona winning against Wichita State?
I had Wichita State winning that game.
I did too.
I watched like 2 games of Arizona late night, and they didn't show me nothing. I was shocked that they made it, but I mean, hey, Pac-12 is pretty weak in basketball.
Name recognition, man. Like all you
that's what it is. Yeah.
And it's I don't know, it's kind of like baseball players get the free agents, Albert Pujols, he gets paid, you know, based on prior performance. And I think to some degree the NCAA tournament is just like that. Like guys get in because of who they are, who they used to be. And not to say that I didn't see a whole lot of Arizona basketball, but I know Wichita State. I know they're pretty good.
Yeah, they've been to the tournament four years in a row.
Like the freshmen that are on that team are seniors now. They've never missed a tournament. Yeah.
And then, like you said, last year, they was in the Final Four.
So there's no shot. Speaking of baseball, though, you just touched on baseball. How do you feel about the guy
with his kid? Get your kid out of the locker room, man.
I agree.
When you're at work,
you're at work.
I get it. I understand you're gone a lot of part of the year, but baseball season happens in the summer. Mm-hmm. So your kid, it's not like your kid is in school. And kids probably homeschool or private school. There are ways you can kind of spend time with your family when you have certain resources.
But you see these women groups are coming out back and them like, way to go, way to stand up for your family and things of that nature.
$13 million
You know what? I would rather my dad stand up for me by going to work and get $13 million versus me. Quitting because you want me to be at work every day. I get it, man. He can't come every day. Man. I mean, there are things that are going on in a clubhouse or a locker room that maybe a kid just isn't mature enough. That's a pretty mature environment.
Yeah, most definitely. Yeah. And you have a 14-year-old there every single day being exposed to all type of stuff.
Because every one of your teammates isn't a family guy. Right. Every one of them isn't a good guy.
Every one of them is not going to be professional and mannerable around your kid.
Yeah. So I understand. I understand wanting to be with your kid as much as you can. And granted, he works in a field where it's not a traditional 9-to-5, where it's not like he's a lawyer or a judge or something, or a doctor who's performing surgery. But it's still your job. And your boss is, until you own the team, you work for somebody else.
Yeah. And they said too, I don't know how true it is, but it was brought up that in the contract that when he signed that he was able to have the child there.
That's different.
Yeah.
If they said he could have his kid there,
it was in his contract.
Well, if it's in your contract, he has a gripe. Sorry, dude, but I was on your back. Yeah,
I was gonna say it was a performance based. So last year he was terrible. Like they said he had one of the worst records ever. So in baseball,
but based on his performance. The kid was allowed to be. If he played well, his kid could be
in the lot.
But if he didn't play well, his kid. But like now, the season hasn't started. So how are you judging?
I don't know.
I don't see how those two things are intertwined.
That's what was reported. And also, they brought up that with him having such an awful year last year, they saved him $13 million.
Oh yeah. If he walks away, he doesn't get anything.
He don't get anything.
Yeah, that's kind of dumb. Everybody's situation is different.
But they say he made over $73 million in his career.
Yeah, he may have managed to make $73 million. Don't mean
that's true too.
I don't know.
Case in point, Antoine Walker.
I mean, it's a lot we can name off that, you know, that they made a certain amount of money that don't have it right now.
My thing, if the team agreed to let his kid be in the clubhouse. And I don't necessarily think that's the best place for a 14-year-old kid. But if they said he could do that, and that's in writing, you got to let him do it. That's dumb to even allow that, for that to be something that you agree to. But I don't know. That's a weird little situation. I wouldn't want my dad to watch that. Go back to work.
I'd rather have a lot more.
Dad, I want a Ferrari. I don't want you to be here every day.
Sweet 16 coming up in a year and a half, 2 years? Go back to work.
All right. All right, people, we got to pay some bills real quick, but on the other side, give them what we're going to talk about, Rick.
Then we're going to jump into Steph Curry, how he didn't change the game. We're going to talk about the Spurs, also undefeated at home that people not even mentioning. And we also got to talk about them fours coming out tomorrow, man.
All right, people, this is DJ Bob.
This is Ricky D.
This is a sports show about nothing. All right, people, we back. This is DJ Bob.
This is Ricky D.
And this is a sports show about nothing. Rick, what did you say we had coming up, bro?
Man, we got how Steph Curry changing the league. For the next 10 to 20 years, you're going to see a lot of little Steph Currys coming out there. You got these Spurs also undefeated at home with a 34-0 record. And they going to meet up. This week or next week, they meet up.
Yeah.
And Carmelo, man, is it time for Carmelo to leave New York?
Yes. Get out of New York.
To leave the team?
Yeah. Nah. And the Bulls come out.
Let me ask you this. We're going to start with Carmelo. Are you saying he don't need to leave New York because of that $100 million contract he got, or because they're going to build pieces around Melo? Because they've been telling him that for like 4 or 5 years now.
Like, here's the thing. Like, how old is Carmelo?
32.
Like, how many pieces can you build around a dude? Does that make sense?
He's going to have to go to a contender. If Carmelo with the Clippers,
what happens?
They got a chance of winning. The whole thing.
Melo make the team that much better, though?
But he's offense that they need.
Man, let me tell
you something. He's not offense they need.
Melo is a very talented player. Awesome scorer. But his teams aren't going to win. They're just not. I mean, there's nothing wrong. Like, that doesn't diminish what his ability. But they're not going to win.
Are you saying that because he's an ISO player, or are you saying that because...
Like, for example, the teams that you just mentioned. You mentioned the Spurs, you mentioned the Warriors. Like, what do those teams do well?
Play team ball.
They move the ball. Yeah. Like, it's hard to win basketball games if you're not moving the ball. Like, you have to move the ball. Like, that has to be a big part of what you do. And a big part of who he is as a player, it doesn't... Ball movement isn't, you know, in the equation.
You don't think Melo going to the Clippers will have to adjust his game?
You gotta put him on
that. I mean, if he goes anyway, he's gonna have to adjust his game because nobody wants to sit there and watch
pump faking with the Clippers also.
But can Melo, you think Melo can go and participate in that type of atmosphere?
He won't have a choice if he leave the Knicks, because who really gonna be jumping to go kill him?
Nobody.
And then at this age, he should be wanting to win. He got the money.
He should want to win. Yeah. He should, but at the end of the day, who's gonna, like, in all honesty, who has a really good chance of winning? Like, look at the teams in the NBA right now.
It's three teams, honestly.
That can win.
Four. Cavaliers, of course, Golden State, the Spurs, and OKC.
Man, Cleveland won't ever have a championship.
Cleveland ain't winning, bro.
They gonna get to the finals.
In the East. Yeah, they're gonna get to.
If you get to the finals, you got a chance.
We can get to the finals in the East. Look. Cleveland is probably not winning. I mean, I like LeBron. I do. As a basketball.
So they don't have a chance.
No, I don't think so. But Carmelo, like, back to Carmelo. There are only a few teams that have a chance to actually win. Like, believe it or not, those are Toronto, those teams, they're not winning.
Yeah.
So, but Carmelo, where does he fit in those other places?
I can see him in Cleveland. I can see him with the Clippers.
You can see him in Cleveland. Whose spot does he take in Cleveland?
Kevin Love. Ship him out of there, man.
I really am.
Ship Kevin Love out of there.
Can Carmelo guard the four? I mean, will he guard the four?
Would he guard anybody?
But, I mean, Kevin Love doesn't really guard anybody either.
That's what I'm saying. Like,
I don't think Kevin Love is there because he's a defensive specialist. But I think for Carmelo, in all honesty, the best thing for him is just stay and get the money. Just stay and get the money.
Man, you got to go get that. Chase that ring. At this point in time, we got to call you.
He could go chase a ring.
Time out.
Speaking of the ring,
as you guys know, we have another show that's on 99.9, The Plug. It comes on Wednesday nights from 5 to 9. My boy Rickey here said that he'd rather be a Hall of Famer than to have championship rings. I want to get your opinion on that, Mo Femme.
You'd rather be a Hall of Famer than have championship rings.
How many guys hold championship rings, but how many guys are in the Hall of Fame?
It's a lot of Hall of Fame guys.
No, not like with rings.
But, I mean, I think it's a pretty good equal amount of both. I mean, like, think about a guy like Robert Orr. He's not a Hall of Famer. He has a bunch of rings. A guy like Steve Kerr has a bunch of rings. But Alex English is a Hall of Famer. Charles Barkley is a Hall of Famer. Reggie Miller is a Hall of Famer. He doesn't have rings either.
But how many guys how many guys on the basketball team?
15? 12 to 15, yeah.
All right, let's just say roughly. 15. So every year you got 15 guys winning.
Yeah.
You
got 15 guys getting the ring. So, yeah,
but 15. It's not 15 guys going in the Hall of Fame every year.
How selfish can you be? You only concerned about it. You know what? Carmelo, stay in New York, be a Hall of Famer, and don't have no ring.
But, okay, when we talk about Golden State, let's just say Golden State.
Yeah.
They win another championship this year, right?
Okay.
You're going to have 3 or 4 guys that you're going to talk about for the next 10, 15 years.
Yeah. Well, wait.
Carmelo going to have a name for himself to when he retire, everybody going to know Carmelo. He goes somewhere, he's going to get paid. I'm looking at when you're a Hall of Famer, once you retire, look at all the what you're going to get from that. But if you just want a ring, you're just another dude with a ring.
So let me tell you something. You don't think Randy Brown can go in places and get jobs?
Not like Carmelo can. A Hall of Famer can.
I mean, maybe not to the extent of Carmelo, but Carmelo probably won the top 100.
I mean, just a Hall of Famer in general.
Well, like, Carmelo's probably one of the top 100 players in the history of the game. So, like, that's Carmelo, that's probably a poor comparison.
Okay, Joe Dumars.
That's a bad.
He's a Hall of Famer.
He's legend. He got rings, too.
But he don't have that name like Isaiah Thomas.
But you know what? Joe Dumars. I bet you more people like Joe Dumars than Isaiah Thomas.
I mean, Isaiah, man, was rough, man.
I bet you. I don't know. I mean, it's in all honesty, you know, Joseph's side, you can. It's just a personal preference. I understand both sides of it, but at the end of the day, like, you're a champion. Like, nobody can take that away from you.
That's
you're
true.
A champion forever. And you're a Hall of Famer forever, too, but I don't know. I think winning basketball is a team sport, just basketball. Like, okay, you know, well, everything's a team sport outside of golf and tennis. Mm. So it's a team sport. Like, there's nothing like winning something with other people, working together to achieve a goal. Like, be a Hall of Famer. Like, you go out there and shoot enough balls and put up enough numbers, you're probably going to be a Hall of Famer. But I would probably prefer some team goals. I'd rather be Robert Horry than, say, Reggie Miller.
Kansas City.
But maybe not Robert Horry. I'd rather be a much better player with rings than...
Big shot ball, man.
Yeah, but he was... What about the 20th game of the regular season? You don't really know. You know, you don't remember.
Kansas City Royals just won the World Series last year.
With nobody's
name. Anybody off their team.
I can't.
But exactly.
They have rings.
But they got rings. And forever and
but
ever
who
and ever.
But who's going to know them 10 years from now?
Everybody who follows baseball will know who won the championship.
But I'm talking about just for the people who don't follow the sport at all. But you're going to know that Hall of Fame. Everybody know Charles Barkley.
Yeah, but that's
they also know that he does not have rings.
Exactly.
But he's a Hall of Famer, one of the greatest players ever, and everybody know who he is.
Nobody's taking that away from Chuck. But what does Chuck always say? He much rather have a championship.
I mean, that's just like Marino.
You know what though? But here's the thing. Like, I think like really good players, your peers recognize that you are a really good player. And if you win a championship, and let's say the Hall of Fame, let's say you don't get in the Hall of Fame for whatever reason, but you were a really good player, like, man, every night, man, Rickey brought it. Like, man, Rickey was a tough dude to guard. He's a tough guy. Like, I think that, in the opinion of your peers, I think that weighs more than in the opinion of a few writers, to me.
Yeah.
And plus, if you win and you know, you got the respect of all of your colleagues and your peers, that trumps the Hall of Fame, in a sense.
But who respects great player? Yeah. Ron Hall. Was on that Bulls team.
Yeah.
When we talk about them Bulls,
you don't talk about
Lakers. You don't talk about Ron Hall.
You don't talk about Ron Hall.
Exactly.
You said the Bulls. You talk about the Bulls. You don't think about Michael Jordan.
Do we go to the Lakers?
Same
Why
thing.
We talk about Derrick Fisher?
Why do you talk about Derrick Fisher?
He got the ring.
Because he got rings.
Beat up.
I mean, but like,
but it's like you said though. It's 50-50. It can go either way.
Yeah. I would prefer something. A team of company because that truly never dies. Like it's tons of Hall of Fame guys who you don't. There's some Hall of Fame guys you know that you don't probably recognize or know. But all those old guys that played with the Celtics during the '60s and the you know early
'70s. They still come together. They still have commencement ceremony, so to speak.
And in Boston, they can go anywhere.
Anyway, eat free, drink free, whatever.
That's Boston.
Well, where are they going?
Hall of Famers can go. Nationwide,
where they
want to
go.
Right, I might say, 100 years old, he at home.
Like, you talking about Bill Russell, them, man. Them boys don't want to go nowhere,
hey, man. You
want
to go, like, where everybody knows your name.
Man, you know? Gold jacket, man. I'm taking the gold jacket.
You know.
I don't care
about
a ring.
Speaking of ring, you think Steph them are going to do it again this year?
I already told you I don't think they're going to do it this year.
Okay.
I don't think they're going to beat the Spurs.
It's either the Spurs. I just say, I don't know who's going to beat Steph, though. I just really don't think they're going
to
repeat.
It's hard to repeat, but I personally think the Spurs, they have a better team top to bottom.
True.
Plus,
they do.
Well,
I mean, Golden State has a really good team. They have an awesome team.
They go 12 deep, man.
But right
Spurs
now.
Spurs don't go deep?
I don't know. I don't watch much.
Like, who scores if Steph twists his ankle or something? And, like, I'm not wishing that on anybody. But if for some reason... He's out of the mix. Like, who else really scores for them?
Yeah. Clay. No, Clay inconsistent. Though.
He doesn't seem to be. I mean, like, he's a good shooter. You know, but I don't know, man. I just think, you know, him going out there getting 40 every night just is probably a little less likely.
Yeah.
You know, especially if Steph Curry's not, if no one has to go out and pay as much attention to him.
And you really don't see Clay getting off on his own for real that much, like you see Steph.
Yeah.
You know. But Durant them. Westbrook get off on their own, man. That's really my dark horse.
Here's the thing about Westbrook. There's nobody in the league, and feel free to argue with me on this if you will. There's nobody in the league with as much heart as Russell Westbrook has. Russell Westbrook would run through that wall if you tell him he couldn't do it. That's my favorite player right now.
Westbrook.
Yeah. Right now. He may change tomorrow.
He's best player in the league.
I didn't say that. I said he was my favorite player.
He's best player in the league.
LeBron James.
I totally agree.
He's the
I think
I think Steph Curry is playing the best basketball of anybody on earth. But I think LeBron James is from top to bottom, from basketball IQ, from every facet of the game, LeBron James is the best basketball player in the world.
Hey, people, we forgot to announce. We got Absolute in the building. Everybody give Absolute a round of applause. Get in on this conversation, man. Who is your favorite player right now?
Right now, it'll probably be Steph.
Steph?
I like Damian Lillard, too, man. He's pretty slept on.
He's true.
And he does a lot for that Portland team.
He is Portland, though. Like, without him and probably, what's the other kid's name? He kind of lanky. Yeah.
The fact that you don't know his name tells me all I need to know about him.
About Portland
is you can lump them in with Cleveland and Toronto and everybody.
Not Cleveland.
They're not going to win.
I don't think Cleveland's going to do
it. He ain't talking about 6 games last year.
Did they win?
He ain't Mike, bro.
I don't think they can win.
Man. I really don't think they're utilizing Kevin Love how they should. This man went from averaging a double-double in Minnesota to now you don't even hear about him anymore.
But that's because he's like your boy Damian Lillard. He's the team. So he's gonna take all the shots and do all the work. Yeah, so his numbers gonna look good, you know.
Yeah.
So who's the best player in the league to you?
I'm going with LeBron. And I go Westbrook second. And I'm just looking at all around game. Steph right now, like he said, is playing best ball, but I'm talking about all around, doing everything. Steph don't play no defense. You know what I'm saying? Offensively, you can't stop him. But all around game, man, it's LeBron and Westbrook.
I don't know, he's a little pesky. He play a little deep.
Yeah.
Just a tad. He play a tad bit enough to
get him off. He play better than Harden, though.
Yeah.
Everybody plays better than James Harden. James Harden might be. I don't understand how he can. I'm gonna say that. I'm not gonna.
This is not a politically correct show.
I'm not gonna take food out of that man's mouth, but I just don't see it.
He's just a one-sided player, man. Just give me the ball, let me shoot, and y'all play defense. I'm just gonna stand over here by coach.
You think that the Warriors gonna break the record, though? Is they gonna take a lot of energy out of them trying to break this record instead of focusing on, hey, we home field regardless, we're gonna go through the playoffs? But no, we're going to try to focus on this ref.
You know, I don't think they're focused on it. I think everyone else is focused on it.
Yeah.
I don't think they care particularly because they won last year and they didn't win 70 games in the regular season. So, I honestly think they're only focused on winning in the playoffs. Yeah, the championship. I don't think they care.
Well, Kurt said they're not going to win it anyway, though.
He doesn't think they'll
sell. He said about a month ago, he was like, they ain't going to beat the ref.
That's probably a little personal pride, you know. Deep down, I mean, he probably can't say out loud that he wants them to win because, you know, he's a part of that
history,
group.
Yeah,
you know. I know you only care about being a Hall of Famer, so that's probably like Kerr has a sense of team, even though he's not on that team anymore, even though he's playing on another team, he's coaching another team. But I don't think they care.
But that's a strong accolade to be the one that set the record and then be the one that coaches the
team.
Yeah,
that's crazy. He's gonna be forever known. Because you can combat both teams.
Is it him though?
Nah, we already know it. We had that argument last time you was on the show, though, because you was like about Jackson.
A little bit of both,
I was like Jackson.
You think it's a little bit of Kerr and? I mean, I'm only asking if it's not Kerr. I mean, well, of course, his footprint is all, you know, his handprint is all over the team because of last year, and so maybe that carried over to this year. He doesn't necessarily have. He didn't have to be there early off. They got off to a really good start, and he wasn't there. So maybe it's him. Maybe it's his philosophy. Maybe he's players. Professional players have totally bought in, which is for the first time in history. I don't know any team. Nobody does
for
that.
Everybody to buy in.
I don't think they're gonna break it either. I put it like this. I don't want them.
That's because you love Mike.
I do, man.
Well, I'm gonna tell you, they got a good chance because I honestly think Pop gonna rest the players.
Yeah.
And just wait till.
Well,
the
he's resting. He's resting Curry. Every fourth quarter because
they're
up like 25-30. So, and they're still like undefeated at home. So, I don't see it. I don't see that nobody beating them boys, man. Real talk.
I mean, they lost to the Lakers, the Bucks, Detroit. You lose to teams like that. Come on now.
Players mess up.
They lost to my squad.
Dallas,
man. Dallas
Mavericks. Oh,
man.
You saying it out loud
in front of me. How did you become a Dallas fan?
Look, I became a Dallas fan a long time ago, back when J. Kidd and
Michael Finley.
Well, not even J. Kidd. Steve Nash and Dirk were playing together back when they were winning MVPs back to back, man. I just like how
they gave Steve Nash system. The MVPs. He shouldn't have got over Shaq. Over Shaq?
I don't know.
Shaq was most dominant force in the game. Him and Wilt Chamberlain. Now. Come on now.
Steve Nash a bad boy.
But I'm not saying he's not, but I'm just talking about
you back to back.
He shouldn't have got both.
But if you take Steve Nash away, do they even do what they were doing?
I mean, but there's a lot of players.
Is he in Phoenix when he was winning those MVPs in Phoenix? Like, are they winning 50 games or how many games they were winning the season?
But you could say that was the offense that he ran. It fit his system.
I mean, yeah.
But he fit that system.
But you put Roger Bell or Leandro Barbosa in there, it ain't the same result.
I ain't taking nothing from that. Nash is one of the best point guards ever.
No, he's not.
He's not?
Top 25?
No.
He's one of the best.
Wait. What? He's not.
No, he's not.
He's not one.
Can you
come on?
Name 10 point guards right now.
I don't even know 10 point guards, but I know he's not one of the best.
That's why I can't buy into what you just said.
He one of the best ever. He's one of the best ever. Yes, he is. Look at his numbers.
Numbers don't mean anything. How many rings does he have?
Oh,
he don't have winning.
He's a Hall of Famer, so he's okay in Rickey's book.
That's it.
I judge my people by how many rings they have. That's when you become best to me.
I mean, Brad Johnson won a Super Bowl.
So you're saying AI is not top 10?
Yes. That's my only exception. That's my only exception.
How convenient. As soon as he makes his bold statement how you have to win a championship, now you get
it. I said to me, that's my only exception.
Yeah.
AI is my only exception as far as point guards without a ring.
Charles Barkley? Well,
point guards.
You saying point guards without a ring? Let me see if I can think.
Stockton?
My only exception.
Man, y'all should. Dude, y'all serious? Come on now.
You know what? He's just doing that for the show. You have enough
trolling,
content, man.
I'm trolling you guys. I'm trolling you guys. Man, but I don't want him to break it. Like I said earlier, I don't believe that Steph is the best in the league. I ain't sold on Golden State. Even though they win and even though they playing ball, I just think it's like a one-trick pony, man. I really and truly do. I think
it's a pretty impressive trick.
It really is.
It's a pretty impressive trick so far.
I think that one coach is going to find a loophole in their formations and in their game and going to exploit it. And when it does, it's going to be like a trickle-down effect. Everybody's going to start using them against them. And then Steve Kerr is going to really have to coach. I really feel that.
Pop gonna be the one that does it. I mean, and Doc, honestly, for some reason, the Clippers play them the hardest consistently.
See, Golden State plays outside in, mostly outside.
Yeah.
But when you got, I don't know if I'd want to go up against DeAndre Jordan either. Like as far as coming in that paint,
he was a liability though.
He won't be in the paint. He'll be sitting down because he can't make a free throw
at all.
Draymond Green, I think that's the only player that I've seen Draymond Green, like, not necessarily back down from, but kind of like, okay, I got my hands full.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Him and, what's your boy name in Memphis? Zach.
Yeah, Z-Bo.
Z-Bo, man, though.
Oh, Z-Bo.
Grown man.
Z-Bo back down.
You ain't trying to come down there like that with Z-Bo.
Z-Bo back.
And then he an old school player, too, though.
Z-Bo got a cousin. Did y'all see that game when Memphis played Sacramento? Z-Bo got a cousin like, hey, we ain't having that in here. We ain't having that in here. I was like, yes, sir. You even though you messing with my Alabama brethren, you know. You know, Z-Bo, we're going to have to ride on you in Memphis, man. You keep messing with cousin.
I got a question for y'all, though. Okay, earlier you were saying that you think a team or a coach would find a loophole to beat them. Do you think if Kyrie was healthy last year when they played him, do you think the Cavs would have won?
They would have had a great shot at winning.
I think they would have won. I think that was the only thing that knocked them off was that Dellavedova couldn't step up and fill Kyrie's shoes. He wasn't a scorer. He couldn't defend Kerr. And Kerr was going to have to play defense against Kyrie because that kid's nasty.
Yeah. If them two teams meet this year, Cavaliers gonna win.
They would. I mean,
everybody's healthy.
If they meet this year,
if everybody's healthy,
if they meet them two teams in particular,
because we already know the Cavs come out the East.
If they play the Spurs, the Spurs gonna win. I think the Spurs will beat the Cavaliers.
I don't really agree with if Kyrie played later. I don't think they would have necessarily won, because like what you're saying makes sense with regards to Curry having to guard Kyrie, or that you would think that would be the logic. Yeah, but I think they would have just found a way to hide him somewhere else. So like whoever's not attacking, like that's who Curry's gonna probably go guard. They would have put a bigger guy on Kyrie. Switched all the pick and rolls, make him take a ton of dribbles. Yeah. Like guys don't realize all that isolation play and all that 50 dribbles before you take a shot, they eat the clock.
Yeah.
And that doesn't necessarily work to your favor. Like if my ball movement, teams would move the ball, they usually win.
Spurs, they the best that day over the last couple of years anyway. Mm. Five rings.
Keep going. Five rings and what else? Hall of Famers.
Sometimes you get the best. Sometimes you get the best of both worlds. Best of both worlds, I guess.
Oh man, you gotta go to the Hall of Famers every time. Like, hey, I ain't gonna keep talking about that. It's the truth, man. I want to be the best. I want to be able to go to the broadcasting ceremonies and win all the awards.
Me too.
And be recognized.
Me too. But you know what else I want to go with it?
Rings.
Them the narrows. I want them the narrows to come along with it. And I feel
like the ultimate goal is to win a ring. Though. Like,
that's true, though.
You don't grow up saying, hey, I just want to be a Hall of Fame basketball player.
I totally agree with you on that, but it comes a time.
Only Rickey did.
But it's only so many teams that can win.
Yeah, true.
And I always come back to football because that's my thing, football. When you look at college football, this is 2016. We can go back 20 years from now. Who's still the same team that was still that's ranked in the top 10 now was ranked in the top 10. So it's the same team. So basically, it's only a certain amount of teams that can get there. That's why it's going to only be a certain amount. The players at the other schools, the Auburns and other schools.
They play for individual awards. They just don't realize.
That's what I'm saying. So you got to be recognized. You got to get your recognition some kind of way.
I see.
So if you're the quarterback at Florida, you're just trying to win the Heisman. Basically.
Well, Florida is a little different, though. If you Jay Cutler at Vanderbilt,
you're just trying to win.
You're trying to get to the league. You're trying to win the Heisman.
But who's going
to
get a Heisman Trophy winner to a team that go 3-8?
But, hey, you're right, but you still can win the Davy Award. You know what I'm saying?
Point taken.
And you still can throw for all the yards. I mean, 10 times. I mean, you can throw for all the yards to get all the records, man.
I mean,
look at your boy who was here. I think he was in school with me at the same time. Darryl Hackett. He probably UAB greatest quarterback. To me, he was, anyway. I mean, when him and Rodney White was hooking up, I mean, it's unstoppable. A lot of people don't remember.
Fat boy
was the truth, man. That's the first time I used to see UAB on Thursday nights when he was throwing that rock. Seriously. And he actually got a couple trials with the Broncos.
It's Middle Tennessee State. Is that what he's saying?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Middle Tennessee State is up big.
I'm not rooting for any Conference USA. I'm not rooting for the only Conference USA team in the tournament. Go whoever else they playing.
Right. Michigan State.
Go Michigan State.
Let's go. All right, what else we got to close the show, Rick? Because we got about 3 minutes and we got to get out of here, folks. What we got to close?
A minute. Got to go get them foes come out.
You like those?
Clean.
I'm not.
That David Blue, man.
That's the only pair.
Bro, you're all the guy. You got nobody to foes.
But
blue ones.
But it's blue and like bubble gum. Yeah, I don't really. I'm not
gum
really,
bottom.
I don't really do those. I don't really like those, and that's my favorite pair. That and the 13. I wear those any day.
Yeah, I agree, man. I like the 4s and the 13.
Yeah.
Well, y'all got to check us out, man, on Instagram, Twitter, SSAN. We got some new apparel out there, T-shirts, 5 T-shirts. We just posted on Twitter. Check that out.
Snapchat?
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
Man, follow us on all social media platforms. Everything. We got a sports show about nothing on every social media platform. Mo Finley, what are you plugging today, sir?
Nothing, man. I'm here to hang out with y'all. No plug today from me.
No plug? Absolutely. Mm-hmm. What you plugging today?
Bigger game, man. Y'all come out to the Easter Egg Hunt we're having next Saturday at Lynn Park. It's at 3 o'clock. Just something for the kids to enjoy around the city of Birmingham.
Oh, you believe in giving back. You've done this a couple times. Okay.
Yeah, man, like the last few years, we've done a base giving benefit concert where the benefits go to feed the homeless for Thanksgiving. We're just trying to keep giving back to the community, man, share some positive light on Birmingham.
Okay.
We really need it, man.
Okay. Bet, man. Well, it's 2 o'clock, people, so you know what that means. We over and we out. This is DJ Bob.
This is Rickey D.
And you listen to the sports show about nothing. Go.